Hey y'all, come on in, come on in, come on in the room. Get in, get in, get in. Call your friends. Get your sister in the room. Tag somebody. Share the video. Like. Get in, get in, get in, get in, get in, right? Come on in. Come on in, y'all. Come on in. We're a little late this afternoon. We're a lot of late this afternoon, okay? We're actually doing a nightcap in lieu of Thursday morning prayer, okay? So usually we have Thursday morning prayer at 7:30. I've been super, 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 super busy. I do apologize that we missed 7:30 a.m. prayer. But it's all good because if we don't catch it at the 7:30 a.m., we're gonna always come back together and do a nightcap, right? We're gonna always come back together and do a nightcap. So, let's open up in prayer and just jump in. Make sure you share the video. I am Ramonica Jones. Get somebody in the room, right? First, we'll just do some commercials while we're getting everybody gathered. Make sure you share, make sure you tag, make sure that you invite. Want you all to join in every Saturday at 6:30 p.m. to WHNO Channel 20. We also upload these videos on Facebook. So on a Saturday evening, if you're not doing anything, tune in and watch the replay to our TV show, Live Blessed TV. It's also going global. Oh my gosh, it's going global, you guys, as of January the 26th. So we want you all to look at your local listings for the World Harvest Network channel that is in your city, that is in your state, so that you can tune in on as of January the 26th. It'll be every Friday at 10:30 p.m. Central Standard Time, right? Want you all to also register for our Redefine Explosion Summit. This is our first year ever doing it, and we've been getting calls out of the works. Like, you know, we received several calls today of people going to register, you know, wanting us to register them, just making sure that they have transportation to get there. So even if transportation is an issue for you, we're gonna meet you where you're at if you're in the local New Orleans area, okay? Or even surrounding parishes. So we want you to visit that website at www.liveblessedglobalministries.com. And we're gonna have praise and worship by Ja'Kalyn Carr. So we're so excited. We're also gonna have Sally Ann Roberts. Y'all, she is like a well-known news anchor in the New Orleans area. But she also has a sister by the name, I think, of Robin. By the name of Robin. I think that's what it is. We did an interview on the TV show, and her sister is actually on, I think, ABC News, okay? So you want to get there because she's going to be doing the grief workshop. Of course, we're going to have praise and worship by Ja'Kalyn Carr, and we're going to have a closeout speaker, and of course, I'll be speaking as well. So I'm super, super excited. Now, that's enough time for you guys to have gotten somebody in this room. So we're going to go ahead and open up in prayer, and I'm just going to release this word that God has given to me tonight. You know, as we transition into 2018, make sure you share, make sure you tag, make sure you like, make sure you invite. Come on through, come on through. So as we transition into 2018, I just want to drop something in your spirit because a lot of us, a lot of people are missing it during this season. A lot of people are missing it. A lot of people are closing this year out and they're not happy. My gosh, they're not happy with the outcome. They're not happy with the circumstance. They feel let down. They feel like they've let themselves down. Some people feel like God has let them down. Some people feel like somebody else has even let them down. Thank you so much, Miss Chrissy. I miss you, lady, and I love you. I love you. I love you. I love you. Praise God. So God has just given me this and he's dropped this on my spirit. But we are going to open up in prayer right quick because, like I say, we're doing this in lieu of our 7:30 a.m. prayer every Thursday because we did not do the prayer. We are going to come with the nightcap, which is a meaty word that God is going to be giving us on tonight. So if you don't get, if we don't do our 7:30 a.m., come on in for the nightcap on Thursday. So either way it go, I will be with you on Thursdays, whether it's morning or whether it's in the afternoon. We've been super, super, super busy. Our Baton Rouge building for Eclectic Counseling Services is taking off. We've been working on getting reaccredited for our New Orleans office. So we've been juggling a lot. So I'm very sorry for being late, but like I say, I'm on here tonight so that we can do our nightcap, okay? So let's open up in prayer. Father God, I just thank you right now, God, that I would just completely, completely decrease, that you would just completely, completely increase. Father God, in the mighty, matchless name of Jesus, give your people a word, Lord God, that is going to marinate in their souls, that's going to marinate in their spirit, that's going to marinate in their mind. Give your people a word that will set every captive free, that will break every yoke of bondage, that will tear down every stronghold. God, in the name of Jesus, we call down fire right now in each and every one of our situations. God, begin to even maneuver our mind, Lord God. Begin to maneuver our connections, Lord God. Connect us with divine connections. In the name of Jesus, open up our eyes, Lord God, and begin to maneuver our vision, Lord God, that we will not get distracted in this hour. We will not faint. We will not be weary and well doing. We will not give up. We will push through. We will see the promise. We will see the work of our harvest. We will see the work of our labor. We will see the work of what we've been praying for, what we've been believing for, what we've been pressing for, what we've been holding on for. We will see the work of our labor for what it is that we've been fasting for. We will receive breakthrough in the name of the matchless mighty name of Jesus for financial overflow, financial increase. We will see breakthrough right now, Lord God, even in our relationships, Lord God, even for divine connections, for divine and kingdom marriages. We receive a breakthrough right now in the mighty matchless name of Jesus for our ministries, that our ministries will go to another level, Lord God. Everything will increase. Everything will overflow. God, we receive divine connections, Lord God, and even a spirit of forgiveness as it relates to our families, Lord God, that there will be peace in our homes. There will be peace and unity in our families. Lord God, we plead the blood of Jesus over our children's schools, Lord God, that they will not connect with anybody that you would not have them to connect with. They will not be negatively influenced. They will not turn into the ways of this world. God, in the name of Jesus, we cover the head of every household. We cover every man, Lord God, even as he come, even as he go, that he will be safe on the streets, that he will be safe, Lord God, from police, even brutality, that he will be safe and covered by the mighty, matchless blood of Jesus, and you will direct his path. You will direct his heart. You will be his consciousness, Lord God. God, whenever he gets ready to turn to the left, you will gear him back to the right. God, in the name of Jesus, cause every woman, Lord God, to come back into her role of being a nurturer, Lord God. God, even women, Lord God, that have gotten toughened by life, Lord God, maybe they've been let down and not been able to trust. Maybe they've not been able to open up. Maybe nobody nurtured them, so they don't know how to love from that place that only a woman could know how to love. Right now, God, we restore the hearts of the women, Lord God, back to you, Jesus, as you teach us how to nurture, teach us how to guard our mouth and our lip, Lord God, that we will all be made whole and made anew in you, in Jesus' name, and that no weapon that is formed against us will be able to prosper. We cancel every spirit of witchcraft. We cancel every spirit of warlock. We pull down every yoke of bondage. We cut at the root every bloodline generational curse. We bind Satan in every work that he's doing against us, every device that he would try to attempt to get in to come against us. And we plead the blood of Jesus that every door will be closed, that the enemy would not even have access. In Jesus' mighty, matchless name, we do pray. And God, we thank you, Lord God, for the breakthrough right now. We thank you, Jesus, for the promises coming forth. We thank you, God, for the abundance and the overflow. We thank you, Jesus, Jesus, God, for the our heart's desire. We thank you, Lord God, for divine connections and divine relationships, and we cut off any and everything that has ran its course. We cut off everything, Lord God, that was connected to an old season, and we don't bring that into our new season. And we bind the enemy now in the mighty, matchless name of Jesus. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Thank y'all for praying with me. Thank y'all for praying. Welcome on in, Miss Dominique. Welcome on in, Miss Juanita. Y'all, we're going to jump right in. We're going to jump right in. One thing that the Lord has told me to focus on this afternoon is called transformation. And the way things is able to transform, the way that those things are able, not transform, I meant to say transfer, okay? So you know how they talk about that the wealth of the wicked is going to be transferred into the just? So there is a spirit of transference that's getting ready to take place. But the Lord has called me here tonight to let some of you all know that you were due a harvest. You were due a breakthrough. Your promise was supposed to have been transferred from the enemy, from the wicked one. Your promise and your miracle was supposed to transfer to you. But the only way, you guys, it can transfer to us is if we endure the process. So many of us, y'all, when we're in the process of the breakthrough, when we're in the process of the promise, you're going to have naysayers in your ear. And they're going to be talking about you. They're going to be telling you, why are you putting up with this? Why are you going through this? Why are you still believing in this? And that is their job. Their job is to discourage you. Their job is to talk you out of your breakthrough. Their job is to talk you out of your promise. Why is that their job? Why is that their job? Come on, somebody, to talk you out of your breakthrough. Well, God needs to know, how bad do you want this thing? And if you only want it according to what your friends tell you, if you only want it based on what people are saying about you, if you only want it when the situation is looking good, when you only want it when it's already in breakthrough, when it's already in overflow, when it's already has manifested, if you only want it then guess what? You don't qualify for it. Because you really don't want it bad enough. I was doing my ministry as I always do. I'm listening, you know, to just the word of God, just having it in my ear as I'm working, as I'm driving, as I'm getting in the elevator, going to the office, right? And there was two different messages, but both of the messages talked about the very same thing. And in the message, they talked about a lady whose daughter had been possessed, okay? So this lady's daughter was going through a situation, and she came to Jesus, and of course I'm paraphrasing, and she was asking Jesus to set her daughter free. And Jesus was telling her, well, why would I give the children's bread to a dog? My gosh, why would I give the children's bread to a dog? And that lady right there could have got caught up in pride. Right there, it wasn't looking good for him to call her a dog. Come on, somebody. Right there, she was humiliated. Right there, she was being talked about, because I'm sure that the people around her was whispering. And what the Lord has told me is that the saints are too cool for their blessing. The saints are too cool, because you know what? Anytime you're looking bad, you don't want it. Anytime people are talking about you, you don't want it. Anytime that the circumstances is not in our favor, we don't want it. We got to learn how to be like that lady. Even if Jesus called us a dog, even if we got to humble ourselves, even if we have to throw off pride, even if we have to go when people are talking about us and laughing about us and making fun about us, you have to know that even through that is where your miracle is going to take place. When people are talking about you, that's confirmation that you're in the right place. If they were not talking about you, then you would automatically know, okay, I must be in the wrong place. This is the enemy's territory. But people only talk when you're right on the promised land. But God has to be able to determine, how bad do you want this thing? Because your blessing has to penetrate your pride. Come on, somebody. Your blessing has to penetrate your impatience. Our blessing and our miracle has to penetrate what it is that we see, so that we can learn how to walk by faith and not by by sight. Our blessing has to penetrate us being in agreement with our best friend, or being in agreement with our family members, or being in agreement with our coworkers. And so here it is, y'all, and I want you all to like, I want you to tag somebody, and I want you to share. I want you to like, I want you to tag somebody, I want you to share, I want you to bless somebody with this Rhema word for the new year. And thank y'all so much for tuning in and joining in. And I love you right back, sis. That's my girl, Ms. Dominique Gordon. You all have to go check her out. She is a tax consultant, and she also helps you do credit restoration and credit repairs. Check out Dominique Gordon. She's a wonderful professional woman doing an excellent job. Praise God for her. And so, y'all, the thing is, when you don't want it, you have to show God that you're willing. Just when the Lord, when Jesus called that lady a dog, amen. When Jesus said that it was not just for him to give the children's bread to the dog, that lady turned around and said, but God, even the dogs can eat the crumbs from the children's bread. So she began to say, look, I am, thank you so much, lady. She began to say, God, look, I'm not going to let pride get in the way of my promise, because my daughter need a breakthrough. My child need a healing. Some of you all are in a desperate situation. This thing been going on for too long. It's been going on for months. It's been going on for weeks. It's been going on for years. And here it is, you're blaming other people because you're thinking that, well, you know what? They didn't block my blessing. They have blocked me out. They don't want to obey God. They don't want to do, you know, help me. But no, it's not them. If that lady would have turned around right there at that very moment, come on somebody, and if she would have said, look, if you called me a dog, I'm out of here. If she would have let pride get in the way, her blessing would have been gone just like that, because her pride is what would have robbed her out of that breakthrough. Her pride would have robbed her out of that miracle. But yet she humbled herself and she told the Lord, she said, but God, even the dogs can eat the children's crumbs. And so you have to be dogmatic about what you're trusting in God for. Despite what people are saying about you, despite what they're talking about, despite what you're dealing with, despite how bad it looks, you have to be dogmatic enough to say, God, I'm not going to let you go until you bless me. I don't care. Though you slay me, yet will I trust you. I don't care what people are saying, because God, at the end of the day, it is you and I that is in this thing. And when this breakthrough happen, you're going to be glorified. You're going to be magnified. You're going to be edified, and God is going to be honored in your situation. But some of us, y'all, we're trying to be too cool to get the blessing. We don't want to ask for the crumbs. You see, you know, we got to get the crumbs like the dog. Oh no, we out of here. We're gone. And right at that moment, you've missed your blessing. Right at the minute where you're trying to appease your best friend, because you don't want your best friend to think that you look stupid, or to think that you're humbling yourselves like that lady did with the dog. So you're trying to get along with them. You're trying to agree with them. And right there at that point where you're trying to fit in, it's right there that you have missed your blessing. So it is not that God is not bringing the promises. It is not that God is not bringing the breakthrough, but you have to be able to humble yourself so that you can receive, so that we can receive what it is that God has for us, despite what it is that people are saying about us, okay? So that's number one, y'all. We got to get through pride, and we have to get through the opinion of other people. And we have to know that right when we're at that place where people are talking about us, that is the very place where the promise is at. That is the right there is the place, because if that was not where the promise was at, they would not even be talking. You wouldn't even feel humiliated. That lady knew where her miracle was at. And right there when Jesus was calling her a dog, she knew, okay, look, I might be humiliated, but I'm not going to get off of this territory. I'm not going to get out of the jurisdiction. I'm not going to get out of the promise of this breakthrough. Even if I got to be humiliated, I'm going to stay right here, because I'm not going to give up the ground. And many of us are giving up the ground right where the breakthrough is getting ready to happen, because we have let pride rob us, and then we go back and we accuse other people. And so what if that lady would have turned around and said, well, Jesus, you know, he got an attitude. He didn't want to bless me. He didn't want to heal my daughter. That lady could have walked away and said that. And guess what? She would have been wrong, because if she would have stood there and humbled healed herself, her daughter could have gotten the healing. There was a second incident as well. A man by the name of Naaman, I think it was. He had leprosy, and he was told to dip in the muddy, dirty Jordan River. And he immediately said, "Oh no, I'm not dipping my body into this dirty, muddy river." He said, "There's so many other rivers where I can go, and I could have been able to dip in those rivers and get cleansed of leprosy." But he humbled himself, and right there, he did not think that he was better than that muddy, dirty water. But he humbled himself, and he dipped 7 times, and that's where his miracle was at. Your miracle is often in a place of humiliation. Your miracle is often in a place where other people do not agree with your decisions, where people are talking about you. But right there, that is where your miracle is at. If Naaman's miracle was right there in muddy, dirty water, if that lady's miracle was right there at a table where she was being called a dog, if Jesus' miracle was right there where he was being beat, stripped, and hung up on a cross, and then he was hung there naked with no clothes on, if his miracle was right there in a place of humiliation, but he had to humble himself unto the cross, and he uttered not a mumbling word out of his mouth, if his miracle was there, then your miracle is gonna be there as well. And so you can't be too cool. Come on, that's it, Miss Dominique. You can't be too cool to humble yourself, because the minute you get out of that place and you let that pride talk you out of your blessing, that's when doors is getting ready to close for you, because you have missed your season. Naaman could have missed his season. Naaman could have said, "Oh no, I'm not dipping in no muddy, dirty water." Welcome, Minister Pamela. Welcome, lady. Love you so much. Good to see you. Naaman could have said, "Oh no, I'm not dipping in no muddy, dirty water." But guess what? He would have went on, and he would have still been sick of leprosy, and he possibly could have died from that leprosy. So here it is. Hey, Jawaski, good to see you. That's family. God bless you, sir. God bless you, pastor. And so right there, he could have walked out, and he could have stated, "Look, I'm not dipping in no muddy, dirty water." But guess what? He would have walked away from that situation, still praying to God for a healing, still praying to God for a breakthrough, because he missed his season. He missed his open door. If that lady would have walked away from Jesus after being called the dog, she would have still had to go to another physician that probably did not even have the power to heal her. So some of us, y'all, have missed our season. We have missed our door because we let pride talk us out of a breakthrough. And now we're going to be praying to God for another job. You're going to be praying to God for a different husband. You're going to be praying to God for a different situation, when God had it right there. If you would have humbled yourself, your situation, help was on the way. God was getting ready to heal it. He was getting ready to restore it, but he had to penetrate your pride in order to do it. The Lord also told me that pride is not the issue for everybody. He says some people, y'all, are being distracted in this season. He said you're being distracted. Here it is. You know you need a financial increase. Here it is. You know you need divine connections. Here it is. You know you need doors to open up for you in a major way. But yet, instead of you focusing on what God has given you, you've set your eyes somewhere else. Let's talk about this. The prophet Elijah. I love it tonight. I love it, and I won't be before you much longer. We're going to be closing out. Like I stated before, we did miss our 7:30 a.m. prayer. So I wanted to come in and just do a Thursday nightcap with you, okay, in the place of that. Amen. And we're going to always do it like that. If we don't catch it in the morning, we'll catch it in the afternoon. So here it is. God is giving us breakthroughs and blessings and miracles, okay? And it's right in front of you. And it might be, even as it was with Elijah, just a small cloud, maybe the size of a fist, the size of a hand. And you're, instead of you looking at that small cloud, you're looking at somebody else's abundance of rain. You're looking at somebody else walk into their breakthrough season, and you're getting ready to miss that small cloud. You're getting ready to miss that small stream. You're getting ready to miss what it is, the beginning stages of what it is that God is doing in you. your life because you've gotten distracted. You've gotten caught off guard. You have to know that it is the devil's job to distract you from your promise. Because how long do you think that that small cloud is going to be there waiting for you to pray it through? Just like Elijah had to keep praying. When they told him, he said, Elijah, look, it's a small cloud. He said, maybe it's the size of a person's hand. And of course, I'm paraphrasing. Elijah could have easily said, well, no, that's not the abundant rain that I'm talking about. That's not the breakthrough that I told Ahab was on the way. Well, we'll wait till another day. But no. He put all of his focus on that small cloud. He put all of his vision on that small cloud. Make sure you like, make sure you share, make sure you tag and invite. Praise God. He put all of his focus on that small cloud and he began to pray that thing through. And next thing you know, that thing went from small and then it got abundant and then it started pouring down. So many of us are getting distracted and we're looking at this and we're looking at that, and what's getting ready to happen is this: that door is getting ready to close. Because how long is God gonna leave that cloud there? How long is God gonna allow that financial manifestation to be there? No, it may not be making the money that you thought it would be making, but if you continue to work it, if you continue to labor, if you continue to fast, if you continue to pray, if you continue to have faith, then it will be abundant. My gosh, I am reminded of even with Elijah. Elijah had went to this person. The Lord had sent him there. And the Lord said, look, I'm going to give you somebody that can provide for you. And here it is. This lady was just a widow. This lady did not have much, y'all. She had like a little oil. And she was getting ready to make a piece of bread for her and her son to die. And here it is, y'all. Elijah could have easily said, y'all, this is not enough. He could have easily allowed himself to get distracted and start saying, well, look, oh no, I'm going to go to somebody else's house. I'm going to ask somebody else. But he honed in on that thing. Some of y'all, let me tell you this right here, because God has just released me to do it. There are people that God have set in your life. Come on, y'all. This is good. This is good. There is people that God have set in your life. And let me tell you, they are being obedient to you. They are honoring you. They're doing everything that God has asked them to do as it relates to you, as it relates to your vision. But if your eyes is distracted elsewhere, and if you are not really working that relationship, or if you're not really working that breakthrough, or you're not really working that promise, if you're not cultivating that manifestation, those people can get released from that assignment and you will miss that opportunity. You will miss that divine connection. And so this is what you have to do, y'all. When God sends somebody into your life, you cannot get distracted on other things and miss your breakthrough season. Because what's going to happen is it looks like it's okay right now, but years down the line, months down the line, you're going to be thinking, Lord God, where is that breakthrough? Where is that promise? Where? And God is going to tell you, I had it right there, but you did not cultivate it. You did not labor it. You were distracted, and now that person has been released, and now they are in a place of abundance. You have to also take a look at this, y'all. Because that goes both ways. Not only can a person get released from being assigned to you after they have obeyed God concerning you and you just miss out. Come on, somebody. But the next thing is this. Sometimes, y'all, just like even in the Bible with Elijah and Elisha, some of us, y'all, we are releasing ourselves too soon. So there is times when God will release you from an assignment. He will say, look, you've been working at that job long enough and they've not promoted you. You've been laboring with this situation long enough, and God will release that, and then now you're out, okay? But then there is an opposite of such a thing where you release yourself too early. Oh my gosh! And all of this has caused people to miss their year. All of this has caused people to get to the end of 2017 and they're figuring out, well, where's the promise? Where's the breakthrough? The promise was there, but you was distracted. Where's the breakthrough at. The promise was there, but you did not want to humble yourself because pride got in the way. Where is the breakthrough? Where is the breakthrough? The promise was there, but you thought it was too small. And when you only saw that it was the size of a man's fist, you didn't think enough to labor on that small thing to bring it into abundance. So a lot of us, y'all, are missing our breakthrough, not because God did not bring it, but because we are not identifying it and we're not doing right by the doors that God has given us. And now God is able to close those doors. Even like we talked about with Naaman, if Naaman would have been too prideful to dip in that water, he would have missed his healing. But then he would have walked away from there trying to pray for another physician to make him whole. Oh no, after you've left that breakthrough, it's over with now. It's done. The next thing, y'all, the same way God can release you from an assignment is somewhat, y'all, you know, and okay, you've obeyed God. You're getting ready to reap your harvest because you were obedient to that person that you was assigned to, whether it was in ministry, whether it was in connection, whether it was in business. So you was honest with that person. You obeyed that assignment. God can release you from that. There is another thing, you guys, when you release yourself too soon. When you release yourself too soon, what happened is you don't allow yourself the ability to get the transference, okay? And that's what we're talking about, y'all. We talked about how the wealth of the wicked is going to be transferred and laid up for the just. Well, there is a process in order for you to obtain those transferences. And many of us, y'all, we think that this stuff is going to just drop out the sky. We think that we don't have to labor. You know, we're going to be impatient and we're going to be in pride and still get this transference. No, you have to be able to humble yourself. You have to be patient and you have to stay the course long enough for God to transfer that mantle onto you. If you release yourself too early, you will miss out on the blessing. You will miss out on the breakthrough. And you're going to be wondering, well, why is my ministry not going to the next level? It's because the peace that you were supposed to get, you didn't stay at that church long enough for them to deposit it into you. Well, why is my marriage not going to the next level? Where it could definitely be because you did not labor in prayer long enough. Maybe God wanted you to be in prayer for 6 months, but after 3 months, you got out of prayer because you figured I'm not really seeing what I want to see. So when you release yourself off of these assignments, when you release yourself from these positions, you are missing your blessing. You're missing your breakthrough. And down the line, you're going to get to a place where you're stuck. You're going to get to a place where you're stagnated. You're going to get to a place where, God, where is the breakthrough at? The breakthrough, you left it back there. You have to go. And that's why we tell you all to persevere when you're going through things. Go ahead and humble yourself. Go ahead and don't worry about people talking about you, because your ear is to God. Your ear is to the Lord. You're not focused on what people are talking about, because you've made up in your mind that, God, I'm not going to let you go until you bless me. So some of us are going into 2018 and we have suffered miscarriages because we got out of our assignment. We got out of our position. We got out of the way of the promise. We let pride choke it out. We let impatience choke it out. And just like Naaman, if Naaman would have been too prideful, he would have walked away still needing a healing. And so down the line, he still would have had to go through the same process all over again. I need you to like, tag, share, and invite. How do I know that people can get out of their assignment too early? How do I know that you can forfeit your promise because you release yourself before you could get the transference, before you could get the deposit of wisdom, before you could get the deposit of wealth, before you could get the deposit of your promise? You release yourself too early. How do I know that that is such a thing? Well, right here, you guys, in 2 Kings, And it's in chapter 2, and it is in verse 9. And it says, and we're talking about Elijah and Elisha, because I like to add Bible to what we're talking about so that you don't miss your next season, okay? So next time when you see that door, if it might be the size of a small fist, but you're going to hold on to it. God might be telling you to dip in muddy water, but you're going to do it with humility. God might be telling you to sit at a table where the people are calling you a dog and they're talking about you behind your back, but you're going to sit right there and get your breakthrough. And guess what? And you're going to obey that situation. You're going to obey that assignment until God releases you from it. How do I know you can release yourself too soon and miss your promise? And when you miss your promise, you're missing your transference. You're missing your transference. There's people that might be talking about you, might be laughing at you, but you're not worried about it, because when the favor on that person transfer over to you, then you're going to understand why you had to suffer and go through what you had to go through. Right here, you guys, in chapter 2, that's 2 Kings and verse 9, it says, and it came to pass when they were gone over that Elijah said unto Elisha, ask what I shall do for you before I be taken away from you. And Elijah said, I pray you, let a double portion of your spirit be upon me. And he said, you have asked a hard thing. Nevertheless, if you see me when I am taken from you, it shall be so unto you. But if not, it shall not be so. And so what Elijah was saying is, look, if you hang with me until I go, then you will receive that double portion. Then you will receive that breakthrough. Then you will receive your heart's desire. But if you release yourself away from me before the time, you won't even be here to receive the double portion that you've been asking for. So that's why you have to stay in the position regardless of what people are saying, because you already know that if I get out of position too soon, I'm gonna forfeit the breakthrough. So what if they're talking about me? So what if I have to humble myself? So what if they're laughing? So what if it looks small? It doesn't matter, because when the breakthrough comes, I'm gonna have the double portion that I've been asking for. I'm gonna have the promise that I've been praying for. I'm gonna have the abundant overflow that I've been laboring for. But if you release yourself from that connection too soon, you're gonna miss that transference. So here it is, you guys. Elijah was going to transfer his mantle on Elisha. He was gonna transfer it, but he was telling Elijah, you have to be here when I leave and go away from you. You have to still be here in order to receive this mantle, in order to receive this double portion, in order to receive this transference. And I'm gonna tell you this, not only is it pride that has gotten some people in trouble, that have gotten some of us in trouble, not only is it impatience that have gotten some of us in trouble, not only is it us trying to be too cool, come on somebody, that have gotten some of us in trouble. We don't want to humble ourselves for the blessing. You know, we want to be cool. We want to have swag with it. But guess what? You can have swag. But that lady was able to say, guess what? God, even the dogs can eat some of these crumbs, okay? So that lady put all her cool to the side, and she put her miracle at the forefront. She put her promise at the forefront. She put her breakthrough as the forefront. Come on, don't let pride forfeit the breakthrough. And that's what happens, Minister Pam, in some cases. And so you guys, in the case of this situation, we don't want to let pride, we don't want to let impatience, and we don't want to be too cool and miss the blessing. And in some of the cases, y'all, we're getting out of position. So we're out of position and we can't get the transference. And a lot of times, y'all, we're getting out of position because, you guys, oh, now I know we might lose some people on this. We're getting out of position because of jealousy. Jealousy, 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 jealousy. We're getting out of position because the Bible says that in order for God to release you into your assignment, you have to be faithful to another man's work. You got to be faithful. That means that you have to labor for what they're believing in God for. You have to trust God for what they're believing in God for. And it's not that you're not going to be blessed. Yes, you're going to be blessed because you're going to reap the harvest for what you have sowed into their ministry. You're going to reap the harvest for the prayers that you have prayed for their marriage. But you can't be jealous of these people's marriage and think that God is going to give you yours. You can't be jealous of their ministry and think that God is going to multiply your ministry. You can't be jealous of their business and think that God is going to increase your business. You have to stay on that assignment and not be jealous of the person that God has you laboring for. My gosh, if Elisha would have been jealous of Elijah, what if Elijah would have said, no, I'm not following you all around for free. And then all these people, they know your name, but they don't know my name. You know, you getting these miracles and you getting credit for breakthrough and blessing, and you want me to follow you around? I'm not doing that. Okay, well, that's why you just missed your promise. That's why you just missed your breakthrough. Because not only is it pride, not only is it impatience, not only is it an inability to stay in position, but it's an underlying issue of jealousy, you guys. And you cannot let jealousy get you out of your place. You can't start getting envious of the people that's around you, and now you're getting distracted of the assignment that God has placed you on because you're seeing them increase. As they increase, you have to know that if I labor with them, if I sow into this, the same God that brought their harvest is the same God that's going to bring my harvest. And so, y'all, these are the things that is choking out our promises. We're letting jealousy get in the way because God put you on assignment to pray for those people's marriage. And here it is, their marriage is getting better, and now you didn't stop praying because you feel like, well, look, that ain't happening in my marriage. No. You have to still labor. Put the jealousy to the side. Kick the jealousy out. Tell the devil that he is a lie, and understand that the same God that is able to restore their marriage, the same God that is able to pour down blessings on their ministry, the same God that is able to expand their business is the same God that's going to do it for you. But you have to be faithful to another man's work so that God can open up those doors for you. So, girl, we're going to do a quick recap, and we're going to close out in prayer. This has been good, because guess what, y'all? Many of you all have been saying, well, I don't know, 2017, it didn't do what it needs to do. I didn't get my blessing. I didn't get my breakthrough. I didn't get what I needed. No. It was there, but did you humble yourself? Come on, y'all. It was there, but did you remain humble? Were you able to humble yourself enough to say that even the dogs, call me a dog all you want to, but even the dogs can eat crumbs from the children's bread. Amen. So the blessings was there. Did you humble yourself? Did you stay patient? Did you wait patiently? The blessing was there, but come on, were you too caught up in the voices of the people that was around you, trying to be cool, trying to please them? Come on, somebody. If even Jesus had to humble himself to the cross in order for him to be seated at the right hand side of the Father, praise God, thank you, lady, in order for him to be seated at the right hand side of the Father, and that is the Son of God, and he was stripped, he was beat, he was bruised, he was naked, he was hung on the cross. What make you think that you're gonna be cool and walk into your miracle? What make you think you're gonna be cool and walk into your blessing? No. You have to humble yourself. You have to learn how to be patient. Make sure you share, like, tag, and invite. Humble yourself. Learn how to be patient. Stay in position. Do not get out of position. Do not give up the territory to your promise. And do not let jealousy get in the way. Okay? Because if Elisha would have gotten jealous of Elijah, then guess what? That spirit of jealousy would have made him detach away from Elijah, and he would have never got that transference of a double portion. He would have never got that breakthrough. He would have never got that promise, because the Bible says quite clearly, God bless you, sir. God bless you. The Bible says quite clearly that in order for God to bless you with yours, you have to be faithful unto another man's work. So what spirit is it that is causing you not to be faithful to sow the seed that you're going to need down the line for your blessing and for your breakthrough and for your harvest? What spirit is it that's choking out your promise? What spirit is it that's choking out your blessing? What spirit is it that has you at the end of 2017 leaving empty when God's will was for you to leave full? So not only can you not have pride, come on somebody, not only can you not have impatience, not only can you not get out of your position too fast, not only can you not deal with that spirit of jealousy, you got to bind and rebuke that spirit of jealousy and say, oh, no, I'm going to keep sowing right here because I'm on the territory. That's the only thing that's trying to, that's the only reason why that spirit of jealousy is coming, is because I'm right where I need to be and I'm going to stay right here. Not only do you have to bind that spirit of jealousy, but you have to bind those distractions. Your promise is right in front of you, and if you don't get rid of those distractions, that promise, if that promise is obedient, guess what? That promise will fool around and walk into their blessing. They will walk into their breakthrough and leave you behind because you were distracted and you did not labor and work the promise that was right before you. Amen. And when we say that, we're even talking about with Elijah and the prophet. That lady was a widow. She did not have a lot of flour. She did not have a lot of food. But if he would have gotten distracted on how small it was, guess what? He would have walked away and been looking at somebody else's house and would have ended up missing the breakthrough that God had set before him. So do not let distractions get you out of your blessed place and cause you to lose the promise that is before you. Do not let a spirit of jealousy cause you to stop laboring where your harvest is meant to be. Do not let pride stop you from humbling yourself. Do not let impatience get you out of your position. And do not let the opinion of other people trying to please other people cause you to miss your harvest. And God, I thank you right now in the mighty, matchless name of Jesus, that you are a God of a second and a third and a fourth and a fifth and a sixth chance, God. You are a God of another chance. So God, right now in the name of Jesus, we ask, Lord God, that every door that was closed, Jesus, that it will come open in the name of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus over every spirit of pride, over every spirit of distraction, over every spirit of impatience, over every spirit that entails a stronghold and a yoke of bondage, and we bind it even in the matchless name of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus over the spirit of defeat. We plead the blood of Jesus over the spirit of depression, over the spirit of guilt, over the spirit of shame, over the spirit of sabotage and the spirit of self-defeat. And we say that from this day forward, God, if you release and open the door again, Jesus, it might be with another person. It might be in a different setting. It might be from another situation. If you open up the door again, God, we will give it back to you, that we will not be denied, Lord God, in this place, Lord God, in which we are at, in which we're believing and trusting in you for breakthrough promises and miracles in the mighty, matchless name of Jesus. And I'm going to even, y'all, and I know my phone is going low on me. The battery is going low. But y'all, even in my situation, there was people, you know, that I was connected to. And here it is, I was sowing and I was sowing. And people was like, well, girl, you stupid for that. You stupid. You shouldn't do that. You shouldn't do that. But I stayed the course, because when you obey God, God will make sure that you leave out of there with a transference of everything that you sowed. So even though I was sowing and it didn't make sense to me, well, God, why are you causing me to sow? Why are you causing me to give? But guess what? He was causing me to sow because he had an international TV platform that he wanted me to have. But I could not get that international TV platform unless I humbled myself. I could not get that platform unless I remained obedient to him. I could not turn around and get jealous of that person's ministry and say, well, I'm not going to keep sowing. They look like they got enough. No, no, no. If I would have did that, I would have broke that connection. I would have broke that tie. And guess what? I would have walked away from it empty-handed. But I stayed right there until God released me from that assignment, and he released me after my promise had come. So if I would have gotten jealous of that ministry, if I would have gave into the pride of what people were saying, what people was talking about, then guess what? I would have walked out of that situation just like Naaman would have if he had not dipped into the water. He would have still walked out with leprosy, and I would have still walked out empty. But because I obeyed God and I turned my eyes away from people, I did not let with their voices serve as a distraction, and I focused on God, and I humbled myself, and I didn't get puffed up in pride, and I didn't get jealous, then guess what? God allowed me to sow into that ministry, and out of that very same ministry came an international TV show. So when I tell you guys that this thing is real, what I'm telling you, I had to encounter it myself. Did I want to humble myself? Not always. Did I feel impatient at times? Oh yes, I was. Was people talking? They was running their mouth all over the place. But guess what? You got to stay there until God bless you. Just like the word say, I'm not going to let you go until you bless me. And guess what? When God bless you, you do not have to respond to any of your naysayers, because guess what? Your blessing is going to do the talking. Your blessing is going to respond back to the people that was talking about you. But if I would have released myself from that assignment, if I would have got puffed up in pride, if I would have gotten jealous, if I would have gotten impatient, if I would have gotten distracted, I would have walked out empty-handed. But God called me to stay there, to sow, to humble myself until I got exactly what it is that I was praying for him for. So some of us are praying for breakthroughs, but you're forfeiting your process. And in the process, in the breaking is the making. In the process of humility is where God is going to open up a door that no man can shut. And guess what? You're going to understand why the blessing came, because you humbled yourself unto God. You remained patient to the Lord. You did not get distracted. You did not release yourself early, and you did not let jealousy get in the way. If I would have let any of those things rise up in my heart, I would have walked away out of 2017 without my blessing, and I would have had to start all the way over in 2018 praying to God, looking for another door. So God is going to open up another door for you if you've missed that opportunity. But keep those five things in mind as he do, to remain patient, remain humble, do not get distracted, do not get jealous, and do not release yourself from that assignment. Until he bless you. Don't let him go until he bless you, so you can leave out full and not empty. Amen. God bless you all. Like, tag, share, and invite, and tune in to that international TV show. It's going to be on World Harvest Network starting January the 26th. It's going to be every Friday at 10:30 p.m. Central Standard Time. Set your alarm, and every Thursday, meet me here, whether it's 7:30 a.m. for morning prayer or whether it's for our Thursday nightcap. Love you so much, Dominique Gordon. Visit her page, you guys. She's a great tax consultant as well as credit restorer. Thank you so much for your love. Congratulations. Thank you, lady. God bless you, Minister Pamela Arbonnot. God bless you, Maxwell, Mr. Maxwell, and God bless you, Mr. Terry Hicks. Don't let him go until he bless you. If you got to take the crumbs, you know, like the dogs take the crumbs from the children's bread, take them crumbs, because guess what? That blessing and that breakthrough and that promise is going to do all the talking, and it's going to speak volumes for you. You won't have to say anything at all. God bless you. Absolutely. Have a great night.